Hello everyone, in this presentation we are going to study about aromatic amino acids. Okay, aromatic amino acids are those which have benzene ring in their R group. Okay, there are three aromatic amino acids. So let me write the name of the aromatic amino acid. Okay, phenylalanine, another one is tyrosine, and the last one is tryptophan. So what is the three letter abbreviation for phenylalanine? So the three letter abbreviation for phenylalanine is PHE, that means first three letter, but the single letter abbreviation is different. Okay, for phenylalanine is it F, not P. So how to remember this abbreviation? So you can remember in your mind, just pronounce phenylalanine as phenylalanine. So that you can remember the first letter abbreviation for phenylalanine. Similarly for tyrosine, so you write all the letters small. Okay, but for tyrosine the three letter is TYR and the single letter is Y. So how to remember again? So you start, you remember tyrosine, you emphasize for Y pronouncing tyrosine. This is how you can remember. Tryptophan, the three letter word is TRP, it is not the first three letter. Okay, TRP, and the single letter word for tryptophan is W. So how to remember? You can pronounce the tryptophan in your mind as tryptophan. That is how you can remember the single letter, otherwise it is confusing. Okay, phenylalanine you pronounce as in your mind, there is no word called phenylalanine. Tyrosine you emphasize Y, tyrosine. Okay, in your mind. Tryptophan you just memorize tryptophan so that you can remember the word W. So let me write the structure. So all amino acid has got carboxyl group and it has got amino group and it has got hydrogen, and the side chain here is it contains benzene ring. Okay, so benzene ring looks like this, benzene ring looks like this. So this is our structure of phenylalanine. Similarly, if I want to write the structure of tyrosine, it also contains carboxyl group, it also contains amino group on another side, hydrogen, and the side chain would be like this. Okay, it contains CH2, it also contains benzene ring or aromatic ring. We know that tyrosine is one amino acid, it belongs to two class, so it contains hydroxyl group. Okay, it contains hydroxyl group. So this is the structure of tyrosine. So if I want to write the structure of tryptophan, it contains also carboxyl group, it also contains amino group, hydrogen, and the side chain would be like this. Okay, so the side chain of tryptophan is called indole nucleus. Okay, indole nucleus, so it will be like this. So here there will be NH. Now the benzene ring will be like this. Okay, this is our, my benzene ring is not exactly like benzene ring. Okay, you can understand. So this is the side chain of tryptophan is called indole group or indole nucleus. So phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan are the three aromatic amino acids. Okay, they differ with respect to their side chain, and common is they all the three contains benzene ring. So what are the important point you need to remember? So what is the one letter? It is F, it is Y, it is W. These phenylalanine, after the oxidation of its carbon skeleton, it will give glucose as well as ketone body. Similarly, tyrosine and tryptophan, that means all the three aromatic amino acids after their complete degradation of carbon skeleton will give glucose as well as ketone body. So they are both ketogenic and glucogenic. Phenylalanine is essential amino acid. That means our body cannot synthesize phenylalanine. When phenylalanine is there in our diet, it can be converted to tyrosine in our body. That means tyrosine is a non-essential amino acids. Non-essential amino acids. Whereas tryptophan, again, it is an essential amino acid. That means it should be there in our diet. Now, all the three amino acids, you see, there is no charge in the side chain. There is no charge in the side chain or R group. So that means whatever positive charge and negative charge, it will be neutralized. So all the three amino acids are neutral amino acids. They do not possess any charge in the side chain. And because of hydrocarbon side chain, they are non-polar. All the three aromatic amino acids are non-polar. The other name for non-polar amino acid is hydrophobic. Usually, whenever they are in the protein, they tend to occupy interior core of the protein so that they can stay away from the water surface or blood or anything like that. They occupy inner core of the protein. Proteins are always in a folded conformation. This is some important points related to these three amino acids. And as I said, phenylalanine, when it's separated from through our diet, it is converted to tyrosine. Now we should know what are the important compounds synthesized from tyrosine. So from tyrosine, our body can synthesize thyroid hormone, okay? T3 and T4 also called thyroid hormone. And the color of the skin is due to a pigment called melanin, which is also synthesized from amino acid tyrosine. Even the neurotransmitter dopamine is also synthesized from tyrosine. Adrenaline and noradrenaline or norepinephrine, they are all synthesized from amino acid tyrosine. That means this is a very important amino acid. So what is the importance of tryptophan? So from tryptophan, our body can synthesize a vitamin and it can synthesize a neurotransmitter and a hormone. So which is that vitamin? So vitamin is niacin, B3. Neurotransmitter is serotonin. Hormone is melatonin. It's not melanin. Melanin is a skin pigment. Melatonin is a hormone. Some book they mention it as a neurotransmitter, but it is a hormone. Okay, melatonin. Serotonin is a neurotransmitter and niacin is a ether. In fact, from 60 milligram of tryptophan, our body can synthesize about 1 milligram of niacin. So that's about aromatic amino acid. There are three: phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan. So you remember the abbreviation: F for phenylalanine, Y for tyrosine, W for tryptophan. Okay, we see next video. And one more thing, all these three amino acids, why they are important. And if you want to watch more about these amino acids, I'll put in the description box. So I have made a video on inborn error of protein metabolism. That is the playlist name, where I have put three videos. Okay. And all the three videos are related to disorder of phenylalanine or tyrosine metabolism. Phenylketonuria, albinism and alkaptonuria. You can watch so you'll understand more of these two amino acid among these three amino acids, that is phenylalanine and tyrosine. Thanks for watching.